Melania just heard sick thing Alec Baldwin said about her, immediately took matters into her own hands. Alec Baldwin was running his mouth and said something about Melania Trump that traveled her to the core. Her squad respectfully bit back like a mildly hungry piranha, taking a quick bite big enough to watch the victim bleed out, then swimming away gracefully looking for something better to do. Baldwin was likely looking for some free press when his yapper kept yapping, telling an alleged lie about the First Lady. Baldwin recently said that she loves my impersonation of President Trump, which is something he performs on Saturday Night Live. It was funny maybe once, but then he kept doing it over and over like a wobbly 45 record that keeps skipping and sounding weird because the record player is missing the middle piece. At Baldwin's age, he's old enough to know what we're talking about, although he should upgrade his comedy on SNL to something a little smarter. Melania's spokesperson ripped back at Baldwin with a witty one-liner when speaking with someone from the Hill website. The spokeswoman stated that is not true, which is why Mr. Baldwin has no actual names to go with his bizarre assertion, the spokeswoman told The Hill on Monday. More specifically, Baldwin said the following on The Brian Lehrer Show. Someone told me, who's friends with someone in the White House, or formerly in the White House, that Melania Trump loves SNL and she loves my impersonation. Who is someone and how does he know them? Bommy Baldwin gives us generic information with no source, which means he could be fabricating the entire story. He's an actor, right? Maybe he's acting like he's important and trying to fluff himself. The 59-year-old actor claimed the First Lady told this person, very high up in the White House brass there, that's exactly what he's like. Baldwin has been doing his impersonation of Trump for well over a year now on NBC's late-night sketch comedy show and won an Emmy Award in September for his portrayal of Trump. President Trump clearly doesn't like Alec Baldwin's impersonation on Saturday Night Live. Trump was tweeting about it and calling it sad back when Baldwin and SNL tried being politically humorous but fell borderline flat like a freshly laid road, but certainly not as smooth. Here's a video from during the debate times. The Michael Che version of Lester Holt is extremely eye-burning. It's like pouring bleach in your retina, then scratching it with the claws of a wicked witch. Does he look super creepy to anyone else? Kate McKinnon performed her best rendition of two-time election loser Hillary Clinton. This act is something that's funny once or twice, but at some point, it becomes old and repetitive, and SNL and Alec Baldwin should limit the amount of times they portray Trump. When it comes to good humor, I'm all for it. But this became rather abysmal really quickly, and I think even Baldwin himself knows it. If he's making up White House sources and acting like Melania Trump is watching him on repeat, then he's either stretching for a joke or he's telling the complete opposite of the truth to make it seem like this bit is still funny. Wrong. Sad. One of Saturday Night Live's best recent clips is their translator dog. According to YouTube, it stars three scientists, Scarlett Johansson, Kyle Mooney, Mikey Day, receive a shock when they debut their invention, a machine that translates for pets. That's hilarious because people always wonder what their pets think of them, especially when they. I like Trump. He's my man, and that condescending attitude that made people want to vote for Trump in the first place are two great quotes. SNL portrayed Trump voters as a xenophobic racist dog, but the dog spoke the truth. The dog tipped on the points that many Trump voters make. That smug white liberal attitude coming from many leftists who likely own the newest iPhone and live in predominantly white neighborhoods often crossed paths with Trump supporters. It was usually the leftist who would fail to hold their end of a conversation and they'd fall apart during meltdowns. This is partially where the snowflake commentary came from because people would melt at the slightest wisp of conflict or disagreement. Most people can hold a conversation in which they agree and disagree on various topics, but conversations often went awry when the far leftists were unhappy with the direction the talk was going. Or quite frankly, they resorted to aggressive, intolerant behavior that often felt or appeared violent. They were leaking defense mechanisms from every screech of their protests and meltdowns. When it comes to Alec Baldwin projecting himself as favorable by Melania Trump, then we wonder if that's his defense mechanism. Does he know people are dozing off while he's pretending to be Trump? Is he acting like more people like him than they really do? I think so.